This Good Morning Northwest Morning Sprint is brought to you by Bill's Heating and Air Conditioning.
It is now just about 6:53, time to get you ready to take on your Wednesday, St. Patty's Day, in the morning sprint.
Yeah, Libby Roberts is following breaking news out of Georgia, and Destiny Richards is on the path forward as she's live at Ruin's Restaurant this morning.
But first to Mark Peterson with a look at your St. Patrick's Day forecast.
And it's good news in our First Alert weather, and that weather app, by the way, updated around the clock. We're sitting at 30 degrees, clear sky, sun's coming up in 6 minutes. All right, four things you need to know on this St. Patrick's Day is the fact that it is going to be a sunny day. Make sure you put on a little green. More sunshine expected for tomorrow. It's Friday that we get cooler, we have showers, and that's the last day of winter, just to let you know. For today, all right, in our back to school planner, it's going to be a sunny day today, but starting off cool, 33, light layers there. 54 at noon, and then as they come home from school, you come home from work, temperatures nearing 60 degrees.
Today, vaccine eligibility is expanding for essential workers. That means grocery store clerks, firefighters, law enforcement officers, agriculture workers, and more can receive the vaccine 1 week earlier than originally announced. This also applies to people over the age of 16 who are pregnant or have a health condition that puts them in a high-risk category. If you qualify for the vaccine right now, you can head to KXLY.com for a link to the website.
In Washington, just more than 22% of people are vaccinated with at least one dose of the vaccine, and nearly 13% are now fully vaccinated. In Idaho right now, just less than 20% of people have received one dose of the vaccine, and 12% are fully vaccinated.
Parking was the biggest worry for people weighing in on a proposed downtown sports stadium. Spokane Schools held the first of two public forums on the project last night. Most people who spoke said they were in favor of building the new stadium downtown instead of at the Joe Alvey site as previously planned. But others who spoke out against the downtown location expressed their concern over a potential lack of parking. If you missed last night's forum, you can make your voice heard at another meeting tonight at 6:30. We have a link to sign up at KXLY.com.
Two people in Ontario, California were killed in what law enforcement is calling a massive fireworks explosion. The Ontario Fire Department chief confirmed a collection of professional-grade fireworks ignited at a home yesterday afternoon. It wasn't immediately clear what set them off. One person near the home was hurt and other properties were damaged in the explosion. Officials are still investigating.
We are following breaking news overnight. A deadly shooting spree in Atlanta is raising new concerns about Asian Americans being targeted across the country. At least 8 people are dead in the attacks, and police believe the suspect they have in custody is responsible for all of them. Investigators are working to determine whether this man, 21-year-old Robert Long, was motivated by an anti-women sentiment that has been found in a number of mass shootings in recent years. Today, they'll focus on the suspect's statements to friends, online posts, and prior visits to the shooting locations, if there were any. Police first identified Long as a suspect in a shooting that killed 4 people at a spa near Atlanta. About an hour later, investigators say a gunman matching Long's description walked into 2 other massage parlors nearby, killing 4 more people. All of them were women. Police did not release the victims' names, but we do know 6 of the 8 victims are of Asian descent.
Today, Spokane Mayor Nadine Woodward will give the annual State of the City address. Mayor Woodward plans to look back on the difficult year we've had and look ahead to a brighter year ahead. This year's conversation will be virtual. You can sign up to join the conversation at greaterspokaneinc.com. You can also watch the address on the city's Facebook page. It starts at noon.
Lawmakers are looking into extending an important PPP deadline for businesses. The deadline for small businesses to apply for a loan from the Paycheck Protection Program is March 31st. Lawmakers approved another $7 billion for the program that was included in the massive COVID relief bill. But representatives say the additional funds are of little use if the March deadline isn't pushed. There is now bipartisan support for legislation that would extend the program to May 31st and offer an additional 30-day period.
Over the past year, local restaurants have had to make so many changes to keep up with guidelines and restrictions, and most recently, Ruin's has made some changes. They're not only a place that serves takeout, but they also have a vintage store and VHS shop here when you come in. They're open from Wednesday through Sunday, 10 a.m. to 8. They will be opening for outdoor dining starting tomorrow, but go to our website, KXLY.com, for more information.
All right, Destiny, thank you. Coming up next on Good Morning America, an ABC News exclusive. President Biden one-on-one with George Stephanopoulos, covering everything from the pandemic and the vaccine rollout to the growing crisis at our southern border. Plus, what he's now saying about New York Governor Andrew Cuomo and his message for Americans who refuse the COVID-19 vaccine. It's a conversation you'll see only on GMA. All right, back with the final check of the forecast. Mark Peterson with your St. Paddy's Day forecast next.